is that time of week again. We are here with relationship expert Julia McCurley and founder and CEO of Something More. Julia, our topic today, I believe, is how to be more dateable. I mean, for all of us, I think it's a beneficial topic to discuss. So where do we start?
In dealing with my clients, a lot of them have this feeling, what's wrong with me? All my friends are getting married. I'm not getting second dates. So my advice is, why not focus on what makes you a dateable person? Have you ever written down a list of all your great qualities? Maybe ask your friends and family to help with that list. Put it on your fridge, review it every day. I guarantee you'll feel more confident, more attractive, maybe even a little sexier.
Okay, so how you feel, I mean, is a huge factor. I mean, that's it's a vibe you give off, I guess, right?
Definitely, it's a vibe.
Okay, so, I mean, what are some other things on the list to check off?
Well, the first impression. And I'm not just talking about what you're wearing, but also how you come across. Are you standing up straight? Are you smiling? What is your body language message conveying? And as far as what you wear, maybe it's time to update your wardrobe, maybe have a stylish friend take you shopping. For men, a current trend or current look is an untucked shirt with a dark wash denim and those nice square-toed leather loafers. And ladies, you can't go wrong with a fitted dress, some strappy heels, statement jewelry. Bet you'll turn some heads showing off those legs.
Absolutely. Okay, so we've got our outfit. We've got the vibe that we give off. What else? What else can we do to be more dateable?
Well, this may sound odd, but how about writing a business plan for finding love? We all put so much emphasis on our professional life and then just leave our love life to chance. How about putting some specific things in writing, such as what's your objective to get in a relationship? What are your strategies? Maybe it's lose some weight, become more emotionally available, get over your ex, you know, maybe see some therapists, whatever. And then lastly, what are your strategies? Why not go and join some clubs, find some like-minded people, maybe you like wine tasting or reading, enjoy or actually embrace any opportunity to be with more people, charity work, whatever it is, just say yes to everything.
Okay, say yes to everything. I mean, what about the whole idea of when you're not looking for it, it comes your way? So how does making a list kind of go, does it go with that, against that? I mean,
the whole idea is the law of attraction, like attracts like. So if you are an interesting, well-rounded person, you're going to attract that kind of person into your life. If you're just sitting at home, you know, watching the Food Network, whatever, you're not going to meet somebody. And so everybody's in their own little circle here in Austin, and your perfect man could be living up north, maybe, or living south, not in your geographic area. So you've got to get out there and just get yourself exposed to more people. And even just people, strangers, say hello to people, and you just get off that friendly vibe and be more approachable.
Right. And to me, what it sounds like is all of this in one actually just sounds like being yourself. I mean, I feel like you could wrap it up, whether you're making a list of things you like about yourself or what. I mean, sounds like be yourself is pretty much...
Somewhat. I mean, you don't want to... Maybe there's some other parts of you want to save for later. But you definitely... It's kind of like a job interview. You want to give them all the reasons to like you, and you're not going to bring up, oh, my gosh, I missed these deadlines or whatever. You're not going to say, yeah, I'm a great girl, but there's this one thing, I have seven cats, whatever. You just want to become that person that people... are drawn to, essentially.
Okay, great. Well, Julia, thank you so much for being with us today. We definitely learned some cool tips on how to be more dateable, and that's what we have for today. So thanks so much, Julia, for joining us.